the fine facade of Huddersfield Station. Built by two separate railway companies. On the left is the former entrance of the Lancashire and Yorkshire Railway Company, with its coat of arms over the one-time entrance. This, the central projecting portico, with its majestic Corinthian columns, was built as the entrance to a centralised hotel. This is now the station entrance. Flanking the portico on the right was the one-time booking office and entrance of the other railway, the Huddersfield and Manchester Railway and Canal Company. Under the splendid glass roof are a fine group of stylish waiting rooms and other furnishings. Six of the original eight platforms are in use, and the Sheffield train will depart from platform four. The two-car Col de Valisette chatters patiently, waiting for its Sheffield-bound passengers. A Class 47 hall that leads to Manchester Express enters platform one. The signal for the Sheffield train is still at danger. The platform leads directly into the twin openings of the Huddersfield Tunnel. The 11:10 for Sheffield is now ready to depart. The twin Huddersfield tunnels, just over a third of a mile long, sprout two enormous ventilator chimneys in the midst of a town car park. On leaving the tunnel, the multiple unit swings away left and crosses Paddock Viaduct. The other track is to Manchester via Stand Edge. Lockwood, the first of six stations before Penistone is reached. In 1984, the line had eight daily services to Sheffield and nine in the other direction. No Sunday service. The magnificent Lockwood Viaduct, 34 arches towering 136 feet above the valley floor and the River Holme. Miles from Lockwood is Honley. freight traffic on this section of line to Penistone has long since gone, and the small goods sidings and coal drops, once an essential part of this railway's infrastructure, have either fallen into decay or been obliterated. Rockholes Station. Thurston Land Tunnel. LMS Bridge Plate number 38. At Shepley, with its split platforms, once again all former railway buildings have been swept away, with the exception of this fine railway house. Take notice. Clayton West Junction. Here the line to Penistone becomes single track. The junction now obsolete after the recent closure of the 3.5 mile branch line to the village of Clayton West. The unit passes the rusty rails swinging away left and is soon swallowed up by the 1/2 mile long Cumberworth Tunnel, followed by Denbighdale and another magnificent viaduct. A most interesting wooden overbridge resting on stone piers. The bridge structure and flooring all wood, carries farm traffic and is furnished with a superb cast iron weight restriction notice. Exiting from Wellhouse Tunnel, the unit approaches Peniston Viaduct. The viaduct over the Infant River Don is built on a curve and has 29 arches leading directly into Peniston Station. A four-car set is next seen crossing the viaduct. In 1916, two of the arches at the Peniston end collapsed, sucking a tank locomotive down with the masonry. Luckily, with no loss of life. After Huddersfield Junction Box, the sorry remains of Barnsley Junction Box. The line now swings left to Barnsley. To the right, the rusting remains of the former main line to Sheffield via Deep Car. Over the River Don again on Oxspring Viaduct and then through one of the twin single bore tunnels. Silkstone Common. The sign reads LNER Private, no thoroughfare, entrance to station only. Miles from Silkstone, the mining village of Doddeth. On a rapidly falling gradient, Barnsley is soon reached, where the lines from Huddersfield and Leeds converge at Barnsley Station Junction. Back to Doddeth. A loaded coal train is marshalled in the pit yard. the pair of Class 37 locomotives come out of the yard, run round the train, and the train departs towards Barnsley. In the deep cutting, the rails are covered in frost. The driver takes his train cautiously down the 1 in 50 gradient towards Station Junction. Flying proudly over Barnsley Station, the British Rail flag. Swathe viaduct over the once Wasborough electric line. In the middle of the dip can be seen the bridge abutments which once carried the line up to Duffcliffe. The box at Duffcliffe crossing, now just an empty shell. Skiers Spring Box. Opposite the spoil heap of the once Skiers Spring Colliery. over the main traffic island in the centre of Chapel Town, and then the approach to the Smithywood coking plant. Ecclesfield box, a typical Midland railway box. The Midland line is just a stone's throw away from the now defunct Great Central line to Dovecliffe. Only a single line freight section now remaining, running up to Smithywood Coke Works. For the next mile, the Midland Lines and Great Central Line run practically side by side. The once Meadow Hall station on the GC, the 08 shunting the scrapyards, the DMU on the Midland passing through Lower Winkerbank. Winkerbank Junction, the unit joins the old Sheffield to Rotherham Railway. Brightside Junction, Here the old Sheffield District Railway line joins the Sheffield to Rotherham Railway. The rusty sidings belong to First Vickers. Through the heartland of Sheffield's industrial East End and alongside the River Don. The old Attercliffe Goods Depot now host to Marple and Gillett scrap merchants. Norfolk Bridge and into Attercliffe Station. Trains only stop here weekday mornings and evenings for the local office and factory workers. Over the canal and then under the track bed of the lines into the former Great Central Railway's Victoria Station. The unit then joins the Lincoln to Sheffield line as it goes through a series of cut and cover tunnels before entering the Sheffield Midland Station.
Right side, Sheffield Town.